try to use basically thinkers. Like, for example, Mac Grigor has said, creativity and ingenuity is not narrowly distributed, but it is. Hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IS. I am CA Sonali Jindal. Today we will discuss about the Commerce and Accountancy Paper 2. Firstly, we will see syllabus and then we will make a strategy to prepare and to score high in this paper. Let's start with the syllabus. Firstly, I want to tell you there are two parts in paper 1 and paper 2. In paper 2, in first part, they ask about the OB and OT. OB means organization behavior, OT is organization theory, and every part is of around 150 marks. Like, paper is of 250 marks and there will be 4 questions in each part. Now you need to understand, first and fifth question is compulsory. It amounts to 50 marks each. It means 100 marks paper is compulsory. And then from 3 questions of each part, you need to attempt at least 1 question. So you can choose 2 questions from here or here. I would recommend you to write 2 questions from part A, because there is a scope of writing thinkers in OT and OB more, because in HRM and IR there is more generic information. There is a less scope for using thinkers, or maybe thinkers means definitions. So I would recommend you to write 2 questions from this part. And in fact, I have seen the increase in marks, the people who in the first attempt, they have written the 2 questions from HRM and IR, and then in the next year, when they have written 2 questions from here, they have seen the jump of at least 10 to 15 marks only because of it. But yes, if you have less time, like for example, you have only 3 months to prepare the whole syllabus, then prepare part B first, because this is more easier to prepare, and HRM and IR can be easily covered within a month, because it is very generic information. It is very easy to understand. For OT and OB to understand, there is a need of some help, and basically you have to read different reference books to cover them. So we have seen there will be 4 questions in each part, and you have to attempt at least 1 question from each. In total, you have to attempt only 5 questions. So in any optional, you get a multiple chance to choose your choice to write better. Now we will see the strategy in the end, but let's start from the syllabus. Starting with the organization theory, first part says nature and concept of the organization. Here you prepare different thinkers' definition. Although you need to, you know, like cram only 2 thinkers' definition, but you have to read all the thinkers' definition, so that in case the question comes from that definition, like UPSC has made very previous year questions on the basis of contextual definition questions, in which they give the thinkers' definition and they ask about the explain this statement. That way you can prepare obviously 2 to 3 definitions, but read them all. And in this, you have to also see previous year questions so that you can decide which thinker's definition is more important. Thereafter, although external environment generally is taken into this chapter only, but I have categorized it differently, because whenever you read the nature and concept of organization, it is generally in 50 to 70 pages, and in the end, external environment is given. You usually basically leave this topic, but this is has been specifically mentioned, so you need to cover them. In fact, UPSC has categorized further technological, social environment, political environment, economical environment, and legal environment. You have to see the impact of all these and try to link with other topics. Like, for example, technological environment impact on organization goals, on the design, on the structure, on the culture. That way the interlinkage has been created in the previous year questions between the different topics. So you have understood, firstly you have to see the micro topics in the syllabus, then try to make a linkage with other topics so that you can write in fact better. And let's move to next topic. It has mentioned organizational goals, then further about the primary, secondary goals, single and multiple goals. And in fact, whenever you read any topic or whenever you see any topic, there should be as much as revision. Like the moment you see the topic, the thinker's name should come to your mind. For example, for the organizational goal, at least Amitai Adjani thinker should come to your mind. And further, the classification has been given to the management by objective. Prepare a 2-pager note for each topic. Try to like basically specify this in the notes. Like generally we leave the micro topics in the chapter. Try to see whether they are specifically mentioned in your syllabus or not. Because whenever you read any book, you don't see the syllabus. You just try to complete that book. Try to understand. Obviously, UPSC has not said like you have to refer this XYZ material from this. I will ask. They have given you to the reference. First is your syllabus and then it's your previous year questions. Try to refer them more. And then evolution of the organization theory. Under this, we will read different thinkers about the classical thinkers, Taylor, Fiol, new classical thinkers like Alton Mayo, behavioral theories. They have applied the environment impact. And then the system approach, how the different systems in the organizations are interconnected to each other. We will read different thinkers on it, but we will also prepare the application of it. Because whenever you see the previous year question in 2019, they have already asked the implication of the neoclassical thinkers. That way, you have to drive how the previous year questions has been asked from the syllabus. Then you have to basically predict. They can ask about the classical thinkers and system approach as well. So your guide should be previous year questions and syllabus to decide what is needs to be prepared or not. So we will prepare the application as it has been already asked in 2019. Then coming to modern concepts of the organization. There are specific topics, organization design, organization structure, and culture. Consider them as three different topics. Prepare the definition of it. For example, for the organization design, Gulick and Urwick has said, if the organization is called to be the good organization, it means it has a good design. Bad design is a wasteful expenditure. So you need to have one thinker at least in your mind relating to the topic. Moving further, organization theory further says organization and design basic challenges. They have categorized further into the differentiation and integration, centralization and decentralization, standardization, formalization and mutual adjustments, coordinating formal and informal organizations, mechanistic and organic structure. They have asked all these for at least 2 to 3 times already. And in fact, I also want to specify, whenever the word and is used in your syllabus, try to prepare the difference of it. They asked the difference between two topics whenever they are placed together. For example, we have already seen in the paper one, job costing and process costing. They were together in the syllabus. They have asked about the difference. They have asked about the formal and informal organization difference, and they have asked about the centralization and decentralization. I know these are very generic topics. In fact, even if you have not read the topics, you can write at least 2 to 3 points. But try to understand when after reading the whole subject, if you're writing all those generic points in your paper, you will not obviously get the more marks. You have to mention some thinkers relating to that. For example, informal organization, Keith Davis, you can mention. Chester Bernard, you can mention. Try to prepare common thinkers so that you can use them in multiple topics. Then designing the organizational structure, authority and control, line and staff function. It has been asked for 2 to 3 times already. Then specialization and coordination. You have to see the AND here, I have already told you. Then types of organization structure, matrix organization. It is a important theme. Multiple times it has been asked. In fact, in 2022, they have gone in the depth. Like for example, in matrix structure, you will read it is against the unity of command. They have directly mentioned this line. So whatever the topics are being asked in the previous year question, try to read them in depth. You need to see basically positives, negatives, and try to interlink with the other topics as well. Then project structure. And next top chapter comes up power. Here the word used is nature of power, basis of power. Prepare them separately, then the sources of power. Third topic, power structure and politics. In fact, they can ask the power and politics difference. They have already asked the authority and power difference. So difference has been asked between the different topics of the paper syllabus. And for this, you have to obviously memorize your syllabus. Whatever is mentioned in your syllabus, it should be in your mind. You have to memorize your syllabus. Try to see micro topics and create a linkage with the previous year questions. Then the question says impact of information technology on the design and structure. I would recommend you to prepare on the organizational goals as well. As it is in the basically syllabus, try to prepare on the organizational culture as well. So there is a need of creating the linkage with other micro topics. Next says managing organization culture. In fact, even if you have prepared all the thinkers relating to the organization culture, but you have left the topic managing organizational culture, then the whole effort has been made is waste. You have to see what the word is used in the syllabus. Here the keyword is managing. Try to see every word in the syllabus. Then comes organization behavior. It's very easy to cover. Meaning and concept, individual in the organization first. Next important chapter says personality. You have to see, you have to prepare the theories and determinants. They have asked about the what are the determinants of personality. But while preparing any chapter, try to bring one thinker or one line at least so that you can like use them in the overall questions. For example, the topic says organizational effectiveness. How you will bring the organizational effectiveness? Try to use the personality, basically any thinker or any, like for example, you will read the personality distortions here. So basically we can avoid that. In fact, using the personality, you can use it in the HRM. So while reading any topic, try to create a linkage. How will you use this topic in other topics so that you can maximize the use of thinkers? I would like specify again and again, there is a need of using thinkers more in the paper too to score high. Then the next topic says perception, meaning and process. You should prepare it. Then motivation, concepts, theory and application. They have asked about the application of different theories. For example, Herzberg theory, Maslow theory. But then the student says they have asked very, you know, analytical paper. But they don't see, they have already mentioned in the syllabus. You have to prepare the application of these. Then the leadership theory, styles you have to prepare. Quality of work life, try to see. They have mentioned meaning, impact on the performance. Here comes the chance of use of the thinkers. How the QWL, because it will motivate, it will have impact on the performance because there is a vector model. Why I am telling you different things, I know you have not read them now, but whenever you will see this video again, you will find out the relevance. When you will see the thinkers, you will find out like how will I apply this in different topics. Then the ways of enhancement, then the topic says quality circles, meaning and their importance, then transactional analysis. Here you will read about the life scripts, life positions, Zohri window, because they have already asked in the previous year questions. Then the organizational effectiveness, management of change. You are seeing many topics here, but trust me, apart from perception and leadership, other topics can be summarized into one page notes. Like whenever you prepare any topic, you try to see syllabus. Then firstly you read books, then you see the syllabus, then you will see the previous year question, then comes the part answer writing. But when you will join, it's like we will try to make notes considering syllabus and previous year questions, and there only we will do the answer writing. So your effort will be reduced. Next topic comes human resource management, part B. In human resource management, I want to tell you the process. Human resource management is like we are managing the human resource. Here the first step is human resource plan. You know, you plan like how many basically employees are required in the account department, finance department, in different departments, how many employees are required to hire. They are already present. You have to basically make a chart of the demand and supply. After planning, you go to the process of recruitment. Then after recruiting them, you will obviously select the employee. Here comes the selection test or interview maybe. Then after selecting them, you place them. And to place, you have to basically give them orientation or any induction program maybe. After placement, you have to see, we have to give the training and development program, because we have to see whether that person requires a training or not. In fact, in meanwhile, while performance, we also give the training to the current employees as well. Then we do the performance analysis or performance appraisal to decide whether this employee should continue or not, whether he is facing any problem. So after performance appraisal, you basically give the salary, wages, or you know, after planning, there is another step as well, that is job analysis. Like how many employees are required for the job, but we should also specify what is the nature of job, what kind of person needs to be hired. Job analysis is further divided into job description and job specification. Obviously, we will see them all in detail. Now you can see the syllabus. You need to read the scope and nature of the HRM, then human resource planning. Job analysis, we have seen job description and job specification, then the recruitment process, selection process, orientation and placement. Again, and word is used, so difference can be asked. They have already asked it. They have asked about the orientation and induction, difference, training and development process, performance appraisal, salary and wages, promotion, administration. They have asked specifically this word, how the salary and wage administration has been done, what kind of factors need to be considered for it. Job evaluation, then the word, other words, employee welfare, promotions, transfers and separation. See, the word and is used, they have asked the difference. I'm not saying the only the words together, their difference can be asked only. They can ask about the others as well. Like for example, promotion and transfer difference can be asked. They can ask about the difference between training and development. Now moving to the last topic, that is industrial relations part B. It is saying meaning, nature, importance and scope of IR. Try to prepare it, make it a, like what is the scope in the new organizations, like for example IT organizations, what is the, how the horizon is broadening. Like for example, initially the IR relates to the employer and the employer relationship, then the trade union comes, then the government part plays a role, then the media comes into it. In fact, now the public also plays a role. There are many civil societies who are working for the labor welfare. In fact, ILO is there. So there is a broadening scope of IR. You need to see the environment factor is also being included, like green jobs are being discussed in the ILO. Then the formation of trade union. There says legislation, trade union movement in India. Recognition of the trade union, problems of trade union in India, and impact of liberalization on the trade union movement. Then the next topic is industrial disputes. They have asked about the difference between strikes and lockouts for the two times already. Causes of disputes, then the prevention and settlement of disputes. This is the favorite topic. Like for example, if we see, say, what are the repeated themes in the paper 2, then it is the repeated theme WPM. It is a repeated theme. They can ask about the philosophy. For example, WPM can be linked to the Keith Davis, Herzberg, two-factor theory, Maslow, self-actualization theory. Try to use basically thinkers. Like for example, MacGregor has said, creativity and ingenuity is not narrowly distributed, but it is widely distributed. So we should include all kind of employees in the management. So there is a scope of mentioning MacGregor, Keith Davis, Chester Bernard, rational present day status and the future prospects. Then the last part comes is the adjudication and collective bargaining. Again, the AND word is used, so difference can be asked. Further, it says industrial relations in the public enterprises, absenteeism and labor turnover, causes and remedies. For example, in the absenteeism, there is a scope of using the thinkers. For example, absenteeism, it's not to basically like some kind of work employee good. There could be some psychological factor. He might be considering to leave the job maybe. And ILO and its function, this is also a repeated theme. They have asked directly, write a short note on the ILO. Now, in the end, I want to say, don't leave any topic. Because I have already said first and fifth question is compulsory. So you might get some topic to on which you have to write a short note. Don't leave any topic, but try to prepare micro topics in the syllabus. Read syllabus thoroughly and thereafter do analysis of previous year questions to drive out the themes and then do the answer writing. You have to see the syllabus, previous year questions to drive out the repeated themes and then you can do the answer writing. Again, I would say mention like part A. In this attempt, three questions, like one question will be the compulsory and the other two questions attempt from part A, so that you can use more thinkers. Try to use the thinkers in HRM and IR. I've already told you, like you should like make a list of the thinkers that can be used multiple times over the paper. Very like in brief, you can mention self-actualization, you can mention the Maslow in the breakage. You mention about the sanitation importance, you can mention the Herzberg in the breakage. If you're talking about the communication significance, then mention the Chester Bernard in the breakage. So try to make a list on like which kind of thinkers can be used multiple times and maximize the use of thinkers in HRM and IR. You have to find out the scope where the thinkers can be used. And in the last, I would say, try to do the practice of previous year questions again and again. Make a note of at least 2014 to 2024 previous year questions, because there are many repeated questions that can be asked again. And in fact, you will be able to analyze like how to create linkage with, between the different topics. So I am ending this. Hopefully you will definitely able to prepare in better way paper 2 and you will score high in this. Thank you.